Hey friends, just a quick introduction to this video. This is all about the best, most secure way to tie off a pom-pom. I am a pom-pom, a little bit obsessed, I guess you could say, with pom-poms. And I make them all the time. They are a great stress reliever. For those of us who just are obsessed with yarn and the different textures and types and colors of yarn, making pom-poms is a great way to use up some of your stash. If you are, you just need a little cheer me up, I often go down and find a really cool yarn that I have in my stash and make a pom-pom. And I made this video during the holidays all about creating a jumbo pom-pom Christmas tree using my jumbo pom-pom maker. So one of the most important things when you're going to make a giant pom-pom is to make sure that you are tying it off securely. So most of the time what you're seeing out there in videos, tutorials, how-tos is, you know, when you're tying your string here, people tie the string around one side and then make a double knot. There's Daisy. Say hi, Daisy. Oh, and Betty. Two of my three dogs. Most people tie it around once, make a double knot, and then bring the strings around the other side and make a double knot. That is never going to be completely secure because you can't stick your finger down inside of there while you're doing it to hold it in place like you would, let's say, if you were doing a double knot on anything else, on a package, for example. So the very best way is the way I'm about to show you in this video, where you take your string around, loop it all the way up. You know what? I'm just going to let the video speak for itself. Okay, so here I've wrapped all my yarn and I've cut it here, and now I'm ready to do the tie off. And I'm going to start the way you normally see everybody else doing it. Wrapping around one side, right, and bringing the yarn to the other side. The difference is that I'm not going to tie it here. I'm going to pull it tight. And then I'm just going to wrap it around again without tying it to the other side, to the opposite side. And this is the secret to getting the tightest knot. Now you can really nice and securely pull that, tug on it a little bit, make sure you've gotten it as tight as you can. And now it's going to hold there for you for a second. So you don't have to have your finger down at the bottom like you would normally, because you've got that double wrap that's holding it in place momentarily. And now you can do your double knot like you normally would. And you're good to go. Just make sure you have a nice tight double knot. And then you end up with a really great result of a nice, secure pom-pom. So now I'm going to just remove the pom-pom here so you can see how it came out nice and tight. This one still needs to be trimmed a little bit, but you can grab it by its tie tails right there and shake it out and fluff it out, and see your finished result of a nice pom-pom. Here, I just wanted to quickly show you why this method is so effective. So you're tying your yarn around one side, and then instead of knotting it there, you're bringing it around again. And so inside, this is actually, inside of the pom-pom maker, this is what it's looking like. And this is what allows you to pull it really nice and tight before you do your double knot, like that.
And there you have it. That is the most secure way, no matter what size of pom-pom you make, but especially the big ones, you can get it nice and tight and secure so that you're not gonna have a floppy pom-pom or you're not gonna have yarn coming out from the middle. So this is one of the best tips that I've ever learned that I wanted to share with you.